StarCross'd, the Oldham Coliseum Theatre's open-air production of Ian Kershaw's adaptation of Romeo and Juliet is in full swing. In many ways, this is the peak of the Coliseum's year of being out and about, while the refurbishment of the theatre goes ahead. 2012 has been a year of diverse productions in diverse venues, culminating in this hugely successful show.
It's gone better than we could have imagined. It's been absolutely fantastic. I really enjoyed doing it. The company have completely risen to the occasion. The audiences are flocking in and enjoying it in this beautiful British summer. We've taken the opportunity to experiment while we've been out and about, and I suppose this is certainly the biggest show in that we've got a professional cast of 8 supplemented by over 100 community participants. It's been quite a logistical battle to get it all together, but they're all fantastic and have really risen to the occasion.
I certainly think for technical team, we've actually enjoyed the challenge. I mean, they probably hate to admit it, but everyone's actually coped really well and been really cheerful with working in other theatres, with other people and other situations. And it gives you some perspective on what you got, because you can get a bit set in your ways running your own building, your own rules, and realise that other ways of doing things. And they generally had a really nice time working with lots of nice other people in other venues, including the park.
It's been terrific. Really enjoyed it. Can't wait to get my theatre back, to be honest. You know, I don't think we'd have done as much experimenting, so we're all going back artistically refreshed, if that doesn't sound too pompous. And it's been a brilliant experience. There's lots of members of the audience saying we should make the park show an annual event, which I will reflect upon. But I am looking forward to reopening the theatre in October.
I think it's the second time I've been in now since we were let back in. All the asbestos has now gone, as have most of the internal walls, which is a bit of a shock. As you can see, the place is looking pretty stripped out at the moment. Where they've taken out an internal wall, and you look under the new modern floor, and what you can see is the old seating of the circle underneath, where it's all been boarded up. So it's a bit of an archaeological dig here at the moment. You can actually see a staircase which leads down to row A, which has probably been covered up possibly, I'd say, for about the last century. And what we're looking at here is an original feature from the circus, which the Colosseum opened as in 1887. And I think this is extraordinary. There's a detail there. You can actually see on the front of the step, I think it's actually covered in canvas, and that must go back to 1887. So exciting! As we've taken a ceiling out because it was made of asbestos, you look 18 inches above it, and there's a beautifully corniced ceiling, 18 inches above the nice new modernised ceiling, which I suspect got put in the 70s. But unfortunately, that too was made of asbestos, so that's come out as well. Quite a lot more asbestos was taken out than anybody thought was here. If you opened up a void, you'd find it full of contaminated rubble. If you lifted a floorboard up, you would find a nice little asbestos wedge put in to level the floors up. I mean, I think the last time the Coliseum was substantially worked on, asbestos was this magical substance that you did everything with, and I'm afraid the last lot of contractors in here did exactly that. We got a nasty shot looking at the roof because of asbestos contamination. We couldn't get onto the underneath side of it and look and find out what was actually wrong. And what we found out is that the main trusses of the roof, the eaves, if you like, aren't really standing vertically anymore. They're all slightly leaning over. I had a very interesting moment with the project manager. He said, David, we can do two things here. We can either put the ceiling back up and hope that in the next 50 years, what happens in the last 50 years happens again, that basically it's all right and everything's fine. He said, but I don't really want to see you in court when we're up on a manslaughter charge, because we all know there's a problem here. He said, this is a no-brainer. We're going to have to go in and do some serious remedial work on stabilising the roof. That's put about 6 weeks of work into the project. But it's also a quite a critical 6 weeks, because until that stabilisation work has happened, they can't put the ceilings back. Until they put the ceilings back, they can't get rid of the scaffolding in the auditorium. While they can't get rid of the scaffolding, of course, we can't move forward with anything like decoration or putting in new seats, which means we've actually shunted the whole of the first season on. Only by 4 weeks, but we still had to sort of significantly move things on a bit. The theatre was 125 years old last Sunday. That's probably as bad as it got, really. I mean, we've now turned a corner. We're now into building and creating rather than stripping out and destroying. So we've turned a corner. We're beginning to put the Coliseum back together again now. Fingers crossed, 26th of October, gala reopening of the Coliseum with curtain up at the Coliseum, which is our big gala reopening show.